reduce the sound of the stereo. What's up? On the way to Sekenani, I'm approaching a place called Ngoswani, and the place is now tarmac. This still, you know, as you can see, it is a bit dusty. Somebody is overtaking me. This is still a new road. Guys are still throwing up some dust, so we need to go slow from here. I'm pulling quite some huge weight, that's why I'm not going so fast like my other colleagues. As you can see from the side mirror, I'm on a pickup. So there you go, and I'm alone. No one is here. These are just some fittings. I'm approaching the end of the tarmac. I'm now doing 60. And you can see we are the MAASAI school, China Way. Road is following me. So I think we are approaching the end, and the end of this lami is near Ngoswani. Look at these guys, they are going to survive. They are using a motorbike. The guy has his lights on, it means next kilometer is dusty. So when it's dusty, you turn your lights on so that visibility is improved and guys can see you. I'm pulling a pickup and I can do only a max of 80, but I'm not going to do 80 just because I'm almost at capacity. It's fully loaded now. So basically this is how the road looks like now. As you can see, there is a road on the side, that is what they use as the pipers. So this is the end of this tarmac. I think I'm a few kilometers into, let me slow down just before I hit the end. And you can see the road is turning to. So this is the interesting bit of this road. So that's how far the lami is now on Sekenani Road. This stretch also is, they are supposed to do the tarmac on this, but they have not. Look at what we are approaching. We are approaching a barrier. That means we are going to take a diversion from here. We are going to divert to the right. So the guy is asking us to slow down. So we are going to take the diversion. There is a small church there. So while I was coming, it was a bit cloudy. But on this place, it's dry. I'm now approaching a bridge just before Ngoswani Center. As you can see, they are working on the bridge. The bridge is almost ready. This is China Way. There is the bridge. Somebody just overtook me dangerously. Mama is fetching firewood. So they are pouring in water and they are compacting. Oh, The entire road is a bit of the same story. It is the same old thing. Guys working on bridges. I think now around here there are a lot of dry riverbeds. Basically, this place is the rivers are not permanent. So you can see there will be so many bridges, but you will not see water. That would be an interesting observation for some people. So many bridges, you don't see water. But the thing is the flash floods. Those bridges get full in the rainy season. A guy there working on the survey. Yeah, that's it. We are now entering Oswani Center. This is an animal selling yard. The buildings next to Oswani Center. Sorry for the camera shaking. You can see I'm trying to record and drive at the same time. So this is Oswani Center. Maybe in the next 2 weeks, the tarmac should be already here. This is the first center after you leave Wasonyiro. It's called Oswani. Nothing much, a few shops. Here you can get a drink, you can get some meat. The lodgings here are the low end, cheap. You can see the buildings. Basically, the place is just a normal center. So from here, the road is the only one. There is a corner here that will go to Naigara, and we will proceed straight to Sekenani. So there you go. When I come to Oswani, this is the place I eat my meat. It's called the Tango. So that is Oswani Center for you. So this stretch, the next center we'll meet is Ngoilale. So this is a terrible bit of this road. As you can see, the road is full of ripples and it is dusty. So it's now high time that I should turn on my lights, just for safety. The road here is a bit of a problem, as you can see. I'm kicking out some dust. So this is the old style that we used to travel from Oshawa Lami. Now we have Lami. So the issue with this section is these sudden bumps. You can see I've just hit a speed bump, and they are so numerous. That is one of the problems with this road. They are not marked well, but there are a lot of speed bumps. If you are not careful, you are going to smack through one and you will break your axles or your springs. So this is the challenge with this part of the section. And this is the section between Oswani and Ngoilale. The same would be replicated past Ngoilale. So again, you see, I'm hitting a speed bump. Just suddenly, no indication. This is what you will see. This is what you will experience along these lines. See how this guy is struggling coming up with that tank. So again, here is another pump, a big one, unmarked. You cannot see it. And that is a challenge with this road. Look at how what happens when this guy gives the dart. I can't see nothing. This is why it is dangerous. I have to let him go. Someone else is coming back. Approaching Oilale, I think this is the second last bridge. You can look at what we are going through. Look at the other bridge. And this is the line we have to keep straight. Down there, Moses. So this is a bit interesting. When it rains, the water flows over this bridge, so it's a bit dangerous. At least this one has a bit of water. So I just saw a car coming the other side. This bridge is a bit dangerous. So I decided to... Yes! Someone is saying hi there. I think he's asking for a lift. But I don't have space, so I'll help him. Yeah, I think so. So this guy was blasting the other side and I decided to reach. I've met him there. And some road driver here just comes and overtakes me. It's very rude. So this is another bridge. Bit interesting also, no water. But again, these are all for flash floods. So from here now, the stretch goes into Oilale Center. This part is not badly off too, as by the bridge. Entering Oilale Center, there is a bit of construction going on. I think they are doing a culvert. Yeah, sure, they are doing a culvert. Water will be added later, my guys. That is interesting. The guys are taking water there. So they are doing culverts. I think he'll come and do the drainages and that kind of thing. So now we are going into Oilale Center. This Oilale Center is a bit interesting. As you can see, it's a bit, it looks nicer than Moswani. I don't know why. But it seems there is a bit of activity here. There is better management of restaurants. It looks like there is quite some work on the culverts along here too. So this is interesting. Going to be meeting my client here, then from here we can proceed to the site. So I want to use the sidewalk because I'm not really going into the road. So there is a nice looking place there called King's Comfort Oilale. think this is somebody here. So you can see Ngoilale is kind of interesting. So this is how our center looks like. There's a mechanic there, modern version, a bit busy. So here we'll stop and inspect the car. So I'm picking up the client from here. From here we'll proceed to site. So he's just told me he's right ahead of me. So then I'll go there, then I can pick him up. Look at this bike. There's a transformer here. So there's power lines, but no power. There's no transformer.
Let's have some chai with lots of iliki. No problem.